Greetings, everyone. My name is Piyush Prajapati. I'm an architect and computational urban designer currently working in Dubai. It is an absolute pleasure to be able to share my thoughts and research on visual spatial cities on this platform today. Well, there is an evident dissatisfaction in understanding visual environments since past few decades. For years, Rudolf Erniam, a theorist and perceptual psychologist, had argued persuasively that educators have failed to recognize the most powerful aspect of human cognition in visual thinking. My research today highlights the methodologies from present and past decades where human and digital mode of visual perception is quantified. It highlights the important missing link between the spatial environment and the visual perception. The above diagram illustrates the overall structure of the research. With this, I aim to simulate the quantitative information of the built environment and the visual perception to produce the qualitative knowledge as a whole. The psychological understanding, the mind, and the world of information processing are not confined by the skin. Cyberception, which is understanding visibility through machines, has opened up new horizons to learn in-depth relationships between visual perception and its quality in spaces. My study then emphasizes on human navigation as bridging relationship. The visual spatial intelligence hence perceived is the cumulative result of human interaction, visual preferences, and spatial built form. Visual perception is process of absorbing what one sees, followed by organizing it in the brain to make sense out of it. In the law of organization by Gestalt, people perceive visual components in diverse forms, in various organized patterns, such as proximity, similarity, and figure ground. Human evolution has resulted in visual spatial intelligence, which is one of the 7 acknowledged human capabilities. But as humans are prone to using it unconsciously most of the time, it is one of the most underrated human ability, which is why it led me to question the relationship between vision and its spaces. The term visual spatial is defined as the visual understanding of the spaces, mapping its impression in an academic world. It was first acknowledged in the year 1935, and it has extended its influence exponentially since late 19th century. So it is essential to ask, why is visual spatial understanding important? Changes at micro and macro levels in the city and surroundings affects more than we realize. Familiar environments become unfamiliar with change in spaces or surrounding. At the extreme, a large-scale project, if interjected within an unsuitable cultural and physical surrounding, it may direct to de-stress. Pedro Tego is one such example at an urban scale. Its destruction is considered as the most convincing case of environmental psychosis. Its importance has even been recognized by National Environmental Policy Act in the 1969 and various architectural review boards, which is why it is important to quantify visual spatial qualities. There has been methods to evaluate human perception. Studies such as diagramming, photo mapping, and cognitive mapping are some methods from past to quantify human vision. However, there are multiple shortcomings with these techniques. It leaves room for imperfection due to the process of estimation and assumption. In the image above, you may notice the grading system with respect to the images on the right-hand side. Charts like these are distributed to many users like you and me in order to quantify and build up data sets to understand human vision. The quality of the assessment is questionable over here, as the observer judgments are based on their individual interpretations. The traditional method of analyzing perception infers that the denser the network gets of a place, higher is the understanding of the visual and spatial intelligence. In other words, denser network leads to increase in the number of participatory elements of the space. Increase in the number of spatial elements leads to increase in sensory understanding of humans, which then directs to better visual spatial understanding. The same is represented in the form of a simple mathematical curve as well. However, it may cause instability when participatory elements creates visual chaos, and the factor of visual spatial intelligence declines gradually up until point of no return. From this point onwards, the spatial intelligence remains constant throughout. Moreover, An important consideration missing from this analysis is human movement. As the preference of vistas guides the user journey, the above observations are solely dependent on the movement pattern. Thus, a new and advanced method of visuospatial quantifications are required. By bridging in the use of computational measures to quantify human movement, the spaces are no longer limited to senses, but they are also making use of big data to connect people to the spaces, building, and forms. Geolocated images can be analyzed visually and spatially to overcome the shortcomings of the previous methodologies. Images are the direct translation of three-dimensional environment to a two-dimensional dataset. In the year 2016, an interactive interface named YOLO is designed to quantify vision in real time. You Only Look Once is an object detection platform working on deep learning mechanism. It is widely used to understand the spatial element in an image or a video in a real-time environment. This method is broadly adapted in order to draw visual perception and understand what eyes see without any visual alterations and adaptations. Many researchers these days are using it to quantify the foreground and the background in relation with the other perceptual elements from the city. In the other case study, talks about the city talks us in data. In an interactive installation by Lev Manovich, On Broadway is a project representing and illustrating life in 21st century through mode of data and images. Structuring the data in layers with positive correlation reveals city patterns such as social inequality and digital division. In affluent areas, people take more taxis. They interact more with higher revenue generation, whereas in poor area, capitalism is low with fewer images even on the social media. Another outcome illustrates the active zones in the city. They are likely to have more number of interactions. However, the pattern illustrates the digital division due to visual quality. The dark and gloomy street views leads to lesser human interactions. The visual quality is the catalyst to the human navigation. Upon examining the above case studies together, one common factor among all is the human navigation. The testing data in form of images are dependent on navigable built environment, which therefore has direct impact on its visual characteristics. Over past few decades since publication of The Image of the City by Kevin Lynch in 1960, researchers and theorists of various disciplines have been trying to understand how we think and behave in spaces and the environments. Thus, to understand the visuospatial intelligence, the relationship between the visual characteristics and urban environment are required. While there have been a violent effort by many disciplines to bridge the gap, there still remains a gulf between the available visual information and the application of this knowledge. Henry Lefebvre, a philosopher and sociologist who is known for pioneering a critique of everyday life and social space, expresses that the geographic spaces are relational. Hence, the primary approach is to bring the data sets on the same platform for quantification. It needs binding agent that understand both physical and cognitive attributes of the visual perception. It thus seems logical to comprehend human navigation as it works on based on the two modes of perception. And in order to cognize the geographic space, the feeling of orientation is essential for our well-being. As humans, we understand navigation in three stages, or let's say in three platforms. Firstly, landmark learning, where user creates environmental clues from the built forms. The second theory states and talks about the route learning, which hypothesizes path-based information. The familiarity of the space gathered here is put together in relationship to the landmark learning. And the third theory posits the importance of memorizing the vistas, views, and the scenes over the memory of landmarks. It is thus called as the configurational learning. It is the highest order of cognitive mapping knowledge as it deals with the complexity and deeply incorporates the information such as angles, orientation, directions and distances between the spaces. Garling, in his research on spatial orientation and wayfinding, posits the importance of referencing while navigation. It allows the user to orient regardless of the position in the environment. Thus, the images are collected from Google Street Map and are then analyzed for object detection and the social media impressions to identify the active nodes from the city. It suggests which elements of the perceptual world are interactive. The research up until now has illustrated the role of visual perception from past and present. In this section of the research, highlights the computational measure to amalgamate different urban layers to examine the change in the perceptual environment. The field of computer intelligence dealing with this tasks that are particular to human intelligence is deep learning. It is a subset of machine learning where it can acquire desired human knowledge without human involvement. Assuming the quantified layers from an environment A is human navigation and the images from the city. And we can say that A equals B plus C, where plus is a representational symbol depicting the relationship between the navigation as B and the vistas, which is C. And in reality, this relationship is actually a complex mathematical equation. Now let's assume the role of an urban layer X, to which we want to analyze the interdependencies with the environment. Therefore, the new built environment formed would be A dash equals B plus C times C, where A dash is now a new spatial environment based on the urban layers B, C, and the new layer X. It is important to note that the times and the plus are again unique relationship with that can be perceived in the new environment. Thus, equation one is the translation of three-dimensional environment to a two-dimensional layer. And equation two is constructing three-dimensional environment from many two-dimensional urban layers, where plus and times are relationship and are computationally derived and determined by deep learning methods. In deep learning, instead of manually establishing the relationship and rules, the deep learning gives the computer the capability to establish their own rules to solve the problems. The internal functioning of the neural network is illustrated in the further steps by developing a simulation to perform and to quantify the visual preferences for the built form. Here, we want computer simulation to establish relationship between visual preferences, which are the vistas, and the spatial arrangements in the city. The output is in the form of colors describing its efficiency. For the functioning of neural network, the neurons are divided into three layers. The first one being the input layer. The network takes two input layers in form of building height map and visual connectivity map. An important layer that computes the mathematical operation on input layers are the hidden layers. The neuron represents the number of connections which are established, and an increase in number of hidden layers increases the complexity of the relationship. Output layer returns the output data. In this case, it gives colors as the output. In the internal functioning of the neural network, each neuron holds weight factor. Initially, these weights are assigned randomly. While predicting the preference of the color, visual connectivity map is one of the one layer which with the highest importance, also known as VGA, abbreviation for visibility graph analysis. Thus, the neurons connecting VGA hold higher weights or the values. Now, Visual Spatial City aims to train a computational brain to navigate in the city based on data and design. This process unfolds in two phases, explanatory and conclusive. The environment in which we live in and includes the social and physical factors. In the first explanatory phase, the design research explores different sets of data sets and urban layers that have an impact on the built environment. With comprehensive understanding, key layers and data sets are carried forward for visual quantification. The project lays its foundation on understanding the city fabric of London, UK at micro level by overlapping urban layers such as land use map, figure ground map, building height maps, and choice map. The choice map are also referred to as a thorough movement map. It is a calculation of number of shortest path from all ends of the route. It is useful in determining the user's probability in choosing a path or a route to navigate. The design further takes into consideration of social media map and images. While social media platforms are the tools of today, which are the direct representation of the society, visual perception, and technology. The design research further analyzes the site at micro levels in following steps. Firstly, the user navigation data set is gathered from OpenStreetMap to study the number of impressions, the time spent, and the preferred direction of the human movement. The output are the geolocated points on the city. Next, these images are captured along the dominant direction for these geolocated points. These pictures are then perceived views of the environment. The images are then examined for the visual characteristics such as dominant color, brightness, and image segmentation. Lastly, the output is compared with the visual characteristics of the social media images to identify the magic color. The new simulated color is the visual enhancement that the users wishes in the city. This is a step where numerous users determine their take on the visual quality of the city. Thus, magic color is the difference of the color value of the social media images, which is basically an altered environment, and the street view images, which are the real environment, which is the real environment. So in the design methodology, upon examining and analyzing all the necessary data set, the design approach is to create a simulation model that can navigate in the city via data and design. A design that has high visual spatial qualities. The data sets are the output in the different platforms. Thus, deep learning algorithm simulates the built environment that can represent both navigation and visual preferences, or let's say visual perception. The output of the neural network is the spatial geometry. Thus, the preference of the color represents the preferred spatial geometry. For the final design output, the form generated from neural network goes through another layer of machine learning process called genetic algorithm or evolutionary algorithms. These mathematical equations take into consideration of various fitness values that can yield better outputs. Along with neural network, genetic algorithm takes surface expansion and building volumes as fitness parameters. The final objective of a GA or a genetic algorithm is to find the maximum value for the viewable spaces or surfaces through surface expansion, maximize building volumes tailored as per the neural output. The new spatial build form incorporates the intelligence from human navigation, color preferences, visual perception as a whole. It takes into consideration of existing environment and simulates it to improve the visual intelligence. To conclude, traditionally, environmental research has relied only on verbal perception and description of the physical environment. Spaces today are recognized in social relation by spatial concerns. Design methodologies, design rules, and the design summarizes the key concept of visual spatial cities. Upon identifying and associating the data which affects human behavior, the experience, the moment, and their perception, the visual spatial intelligence is created. The intelligence hence simulates the quantitative information of human interaction, visual preferences, and the spatial build form to produce qualitative knowledge as a whole. The design prototype illustrates the interdependencies between the urban layers while creating a new environment. The design is evolved from the existing built form, hence is the most precise outcome of the qualitative knowledge representing as a visual spatial cities. With an executed design output, the intention is to create the simulation tool that unifies various independent data sets by building them on the same platform, which is limited only to the physical and semantic understanding. The design exploits the full potential of the created toolkit whilst exploring the methodologies used in quantifying and qualifying visual spatial intelligence. It thus justifies that the scope of the toolkit is not local, rather global in nature and execution. Thank you. My name is Piyush Prajapati.